I'm Scott Summerall with Texas Instruments, and I'm thrilled to be here today at CES 2023 with Mark Ng. Mark, thanks for being here. You're going to tell us a little bit about high voltage battery management systems. Is that right?
Sure, yes. So high voltage battery management system really has several functions. At the heart of things, it has to monitor the battery cells. But why do we monitor the battery cells? Because we ultimately need to tell the driver how much range is left. But battery cells themselves are quite volatile, so we also have to make sure that the system is safe. And so the system is not only monitoring, but it's also acting as a watchdog to make things that things are safe, and it's also taking care of the overall health of the battery cells.
Well, we have a very cool demo here today at CES. Would you tell us a little bit about what we're looking at?
I am literally very excited to show this demo system here, because if we look at this, and looking just from the top downward, we can see tons of silicon devices, and all of those devices come from TI, 100% of those devices. And that means that every single BMS function, ranging from the safety MCU, to the battery monitor, to the pack monitor, to the contactor drivers, isolated load switches, I can go on and on, but those are all functions which are implemented by TI devices.
So it's really a whole system.
Exactly.
For BMS.
And everything we need to do in BMS is in here.
So tell me a little bit about, I understand, you know, we announced two new devices that are BQ devices that do some really cool things as well. Tell us a little bit about those.
Well, we have the BQ79718, which is a battery monitor, and we have the BQ79731, which is a pack monitor. So we are basically measuring the cell voltages, the pack currents, temperatures, and other, you know, voltages extremely accurately. So that matters because the more accurately we measure the cell voltage, the more accurately we measure the current, the more range we will be able to provide to the driver, and ultimately we'll be able to provide things like faster charging and even enabling lower costs overall.
So tell me a little bit about true range. What is the true range of an EV and how do you achieve that?
True range in an EV is dictated by several things, right? How heavy your vehicle is, how much drag you have, how much, you know, how much are you stepping on the pedal and so on. But that is really affected by the vehicle and the driver itself. But what really matters in the background are three things: how accurately you're measuring your voltage, how accurately you're measuring your current, and your temperature. Those are the only three items which impact something called state of charge. And state of charge is then used to calculate your ultimate range. So the more accurately you're measuring those three items, the more range you're gonna get.
So Mark, tell me a little bit about where TI sees the future of vehicle electrification.
That's an interesting question. I think that we're only really at the beginning of the innovation curve. I believe that we're gonna see more advancements in battery chemistries, right? That's gonna put more requirements on the actual ICs that we develop. But in terms of the future, I think that we're gonna see more advanced algorithms to detect things like state of health of the overall batteries, to make sure that the driver is safe, to make sure that your vehicle will be usable for longer, that we don't have to change batteries. I believe that cars are gonna be more and more connected to the cloud. So things like, you know, machine learning and other types of algorithms can be used to actually, you know, maximize the overall enjoyment of electrical vehicles. So I really think we're gonna see a lot more excitement in the next few years to come.
Thanks, Mark. There you have it, folks. We're here at CES 2023, driving vehicle electrification forward. We hope you'll join us on TI.com to learn more.